It's time for the King Rat Christmas special. Tonight's guest, actress Karen Village. We got stand-up from Uncle Snowman. My name is Stone Cold Steve Austin. And here's King Rat.
Thank you. Welcome to the King Rat Christmas special. I know I have a hair on my ear. Just go with it. So this morning around 5 o'clock in the morning, the phone rings. I'm sleeping. I wait. Hello? Hey, it's Santa Claus. Did I wake you? Hey, fat man, you know when I'm sleeping and you know when I'm awake. So don't even pull that. He just finished packing all the toys up and he was drunk dialing people. Another protest I saw in the news about a manger in front of a courthouse. Look, if you're so offended by the manger, just wait like 4 days and drunk teenagers will come by and steal the thing. So you don't have to worry about it. Saw a story where someone broke into a house and stole all the gifts from under the tree. I mean, you're a creep. But I wonder, when they get home, do you think they shake the packages before they open them? They're probably more pissed off about getting underwear and socks than you would have been. They could go to prison for like 3 to 8 years for a pair of ankle socks and tighty whities. One thing I like about Christmas, well, one, I love driving through the neighborhoods really slow and people assume I'm looking at Christmas lights. But another thing is all the great Christmas characters from all the great movies, Frosty, all those things. So tonight we thought we'd take a look at Christmas characters and where are they now?
Where are they now?
That sounded really cool. First, we'll start Hermie the dentist. Remember him? He did become a dentist, but like many in his profession, he committed suicide. Very high suicide rate with dentists. Very sad. Rudolph, he was a big drinker and died of cirrhosis of the liver, but no one knew he was drunk because his nose was always red. Even worse, they stuffed him and sold him to a Christmas town in Waco, Texas. Very sad. Old lovable Uncle Billy from It's a Wonderful Life. He died in a mysterious accident, but luckily George bought a $5 million life insurance policy. And he framed Old Man Potter for the crime. So George was literally and figuratively the richest man in town. The little boy from I Saw Mommy Kissing Santa Claus. Yeah, that was a traumatic experience. And he never trusted women after this, became a serial killer. 14 prostitutes that we know of. He's on death row, though. We all remember Ralphie from Christmas Story. He wanted a BB gun. He died in 9. Yeah. Not all bad. Bumble the Abominable Snowman went on to become comedy writer Bruce Valanche. And lastly, the Grinch. We all loved him. Remember the Grinch? He stole all the gifts and then he gave them back. Yeah, well, he was indicted the next day for all the thievery and they actually had a trial. So here's the epilogue of the Grinch. The verdict was read and the town folks did cheer. The Grinch was found guilty and given 25 years. He was sent up the river to the Whoville State Pen where he was put in a cell with a lifer named Clem. I like you, Clem said as he stared from his bunk. You're a sweet young thing, and I'll make you my punk. I might call you Linda. I might call you Mabel. I might call you Cindy Von Lindy Von Babel. Clem jumped off the bed. The Grinch shook with fear. He gave Clem a hand instead of his rear. But the very next day, the Grinch was deflowered. The inmates, they pinned him right there in the shower. They zimmed him and zammed him and poked him with plingers. They stretched out his zimbob to the size of a splinker. His last breath escaped him. His body went slack. And that's where he died, with a shiv in his back. We got more King Rat Christmas special coming up right after this. Stick around. In the town of Bethlehem, Mary gave birth to a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger because there was no room at the inn. Shepherds and three wise men came to see the child. Also in the neighborhood was the little drummer boy and his brother Shecky, who had just finished a week at the Haha tent in Judea. They decided to do a guest set for the boy king. Here's the little drummer boy and Shecky.
Well, thank you. It's great to be here in Bethlehem, gateway to the Petra Desert. We're here to celebrate this little baby's birth. Born on Christmas. What a bummer. You get those combination gifts. So what's the baby's name?
We named him Jesus.
Jesus? You're not Hispanic by any chance, are you? Just ask. You're born in a manger. There's good things about this. Because when you're a teenager and your room's messy and your mom asks, were you born in a barn? You could say yes. Little drummer boy, I didn't hear a rim shot.
Well, I didn't hear a joke.
Ho ho! Honestly, this manger, it's as nice as my room down at the Motel VI. It's a Roman numeral joke. The three wise men are here. Yeah, there was a fourth wise man, but we kicked him out. He only brought a fruitcake. Gold, frankincense, and myrrh is what they brought. I want to thank the One King for bringing myrrh. Yeah, we just ran out. The shepherds are here without any sheep. What happened, fellas? Couldn't get dates? Yeah, hey, you, the one on the end. Yeah, you got a little wool caught in your zipper. You might want to check that. Joseph, you bought the whole Virgin Mary story. Yeah, I got some land in the Syrian desert you might be interested in. I'll do some impressions for you. First up, King Herod. This is King Herod, everybody.
All right, all right, all right. I'm going to round up all them babies and put them in the trunk of my Lincoln.
Here's another impression for you. A Roman soldier. Stab, stab, freeze. The angel Gabriel is here. Good to see you. Talked to him earlier, and no, I don't want any angel dust. Yeah, maybe you can talk to the drummer.
Oh, I don't do that stuff. You got any weed?
How am I doing on time? I should ask the ox and lamb. The ox and lamb kept time around. Come on, folks, stick with me. Woo! Is this a crowd or a nativity scene? The cow liked that joke. Either that or he got goosed by a shepherd. You're a good audience for a baby, Jesus. I thought this was going to be a hell gig. Is that the Star of the East, or am I getting the light? Yeah, hip crowd. You get the showbiz jokes. I like it. Okay, we got to get out of here. It's a new year, and I'm still putting BC on my check. Anybody else? Yeah. All right, Jesus, thanks for letting us perform for you. I'm Shecky. That's the little drummer boy. And Joseph, Mary, I also do bar mitzvahs. Keep that in mind. Thank you.
How about another hand for Stone Cold Steve as a little drummer boy?
Yeah.
And we'll be right back with Karen Village.